Today we're talking about gift cards. When you receive them as presents, do you use them right away or do you save them up and wait for a special occasion? Join us on Facebook, search Morning Blend Omaha. We're also on Twitter at OMA Morning Blend. Mary, over to you.
Thank you, Mike. You were just talking about the oblong-shaped football. Well, footballs can also be round, though here in the U.S. we commonly call them soccer balls. This soccer ball probably doesn't look like anything you've seen before, but it shows just how passionate young people are about the game around the world. From the organization Football for the World, Monica Basilovac, Carrie Pivovar is also here, and they both play soccer for UNO. Nice to have you on the Morning Blend.
Thank you. Excited to be here.
Well, we're excited to have you. This is a cool trip coming up for you. How did UNO and your team get involved with this?
It started when I was studying abroad in Africa. And so while I was there, I went and did some volunteer work in Tanzania and met the founder of Football for the World. And it was just really clear how passionate these kids were. They played soccer every day, all day. And so I got to work with them and really looked back and said, I have a ton of soccer equipment that I have at home that I can, you know, send to these kids.
To donate to them.
Right.
So this ball, what's the story and how did you come to acquire it?
So that ball is what the kids use there to play with every day. And so when I was there, I just went and bought one for myself because I thought, that's really cool to have and I want to bring that back and show people.
What's it made of?
It's made out of plastic bags on the inside and then they just use the thread.
To hold it all together. But it's so dense. Mm-hmm. But these are the same shopping bags inside there that what we'd get at Hy-Vee.
Right.
Similar, just plastic shopping bags. You're going to Kingston, Jamaica. How did you decide on that community?
Kingston was a good opportunity for us because Vance Rookwood on the men's UNO team, he's from Kingston, and we thought it's a close location. We have a contact down there. He played for local clubs, and we thought that'd be a great place to, you know, go and share.
So you're not just taking your own equipment this time. You've collected some. So what are you taking? How much? Where'd you get it?
We've collected a lot.
Over 600 items of cleats, jerseys, everything. Covered our basement floor for weeks.
Wow.
We've gotten stuff from the UNO equipment room, from donations from family and friends at our home games and all that kind of stuff.
Yeah? Mm-hmm. How are you getting it all there? You're hardly carrying it on. That's got to be logistically something to think about.
We've packed it all into 10 different suitcases. So there's five of us traveling down there, so each of us are going to be able to check two bags.
Wow.
And so we've measured them all out to exactly 49 pounds. There's a science to it.
Yes.
And yeah, we're just going to check them
too
on.
Too bad
and
you can't fly Southwest where you get your bags fly free.
Right.
So what will you do once you get there? You're not just dropping off the equipment and turning around. What are you doing for that week you're there?
We will work with three different schools in the local area and then one football club that's down there. And so part of it will be passing out the equipment to the kids that are in need and then hosting clinics, doing, you know, soccer drills with the kids. And then another part of it will be working in the schools and doing like tutoring and kind of working in the classroom and doing activities there.
How do you describe the passion? I mean, there's so much that we take for granted here, but as you were in Tanzania, what did you see that soccer meant to those kids? I mean, to adults, of course, but to the kids who were out playing.
Right. Well, first, soccer is just so big in those countries that they all follow their teams. They all, you know, follow every game just like we would almost American football. But really, the whole point of the organization is to say, you know, we've learned a lot from soccer and just being involved in any sport, you learn so many skills like leadership and teamwork. And we've been playing soccer our whole life and know that that's really helped us, you know, get jobs later in life and work really well in teams and other things. So that's what we really want to impart on these kids when we go and talk to them.
So, Carrie, you have 10 times 49 pounds worth of equipment donated
I know.
For our viewers who think this is a great idea and want to support this mission. Is it too late to donate still? And if so, I'm sure you're looking for money, which doesn't weigh much at all. So what do you say to our viewers who are just hearing about it?
It is too late to donate now for this trip, but they can donate on our website. Monica, what is that?
We have our website.
It's on the screen right now.
Yeah. Oh,
okay. It's long.
It is.
Listen, I'll tell you, omahamorningblend.com, we try to put all of our guests' links there next to their clip, so maybe it would just be easiest if you can't jot it all down.
Yeah, it's great. Ours is omahasoccer and then fftw.wordpress.com. So that's a website I set up just special for this trip and for UNO Soccer, and then on there you can donate. You can keep up to date on what we're doing each day. We'll be blogging and keeping everyone posted with pictures.
Any idea what How many children Football for the World has reached over the years?
We've reached over 1,000. Mm-hmm. So we just started a nonprofit about a year and a half ago, yeah, to 2 years, and that's how long I've been working with them as well. And so we've been to 6 different countries, we've helped over 1,000 kids, mm-hmm, and then there will be an additional 250 in the soccer club in Kingston.
Next
and
stop, yeah,
a couple
Kingston,
hundred.
Jamaica. What a meaningful trip. And please let us know if you could send us some pictures. Maybe we could show
absolutely
them on air and get our
for
viewers
sure
to this. And we appreciate your time here today.
Thank you for having us.
All right, after the break, one of the 20-some homeowners with April 26th circled on their calendars, why it's a day worth looking forward to and how you can be part of it. We'll give this back.